this to the service. Just a few short announcements. There's a gray Hyundai with a blinker still flashing. So if that might be you, you could check that out real quick. The bride and groom will be started in just a few short moments, but the bride and groom have requested this to be a phone-free zone. So make sure you turn your phone onto silent and refrain from your photography, because look at these professional photographers. They've got us covered, so we should be good for that. And that's all the announcements that I have. So if you've got a gray Hyundai, that's for you. It'll be another 5-10 minutes or so. We'll begin seating some more people, and then the ceremony will begin in about 5-10 minutes.
Thank you. kuchagua wewe, wewe uwe wangu. Mume wangu, baba ya watoto wangu.
Kupendwa nawe, majaliwa kukuoa ni baraka. Mshikaji wangu wa maisha, oh baby I love you.
And for you, ninabadili mienendo yangu baba.
Baby for you, nina ukimbia ujana mama.
Nijenge boma nawe,
nawe.
Zae watoto nawe,
nawe.
Wale pamoja nawe,
nawe.
Zeke pamoja nawe.
I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Oh, darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're holding mine. Between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling. You look perfect tonight.
Found a man stronger than anyone I know. He shares my dreams. I hope that someday we'll share our home. I found love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand, be your girl, you'll be my man, and I see my future in your eyes. Well, baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass,
while listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect tonight.
Ah, 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 ah. No, no, no.
Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you.
Do you remember back on the first night, shoulder to shoulder, playing the piano in my room? Oh, I do.
Who gives this woman to this man? Friends and family of the bride and groom, we have come together before the face of God to join Victory Shumbusho and Natalie Thalen in marriage. Today, Victory and Natalie leave their parents to establish a new home. In marriage, which is instituted by God, a man and a woman covenant to live together in a lifelong exclusive partnership of love and fidelity. By putting his blessing on marriage, God intended that it would provide a context within a husband and wife can help and comfort each other and find companionship. And also a setting in which we may give loving and tender expression to the desires God gave us. And also a secure environment within which children may be born and taught to know and serve the Lord. And also a structure that enriches society and contributes to its function. When these purposes are prayerfully pursued in union with Christ, the kingdom of God is advanced, and the blessedness of husband and wife is assured. Let us pray. Loving God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, send to us this day, particularly Victory and Natalie, but all gathered here, the blessing of your Spirit, so that they would be united in holy matrimony with the full support of their community in front of your face, be lifted up in holy matrimony. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, congregation, I want you to invite you to rise, and we are going to sing together one of their favorite songs, In Christ Alone. It's printed in your order of worship, of service.
Thank you.
may be seated, and I also invite the wedding party to take a seat, and Natalie and Victory to take a seat, and I will invite the rest of you to open your Bibles. You can use the pew Bibles in the seat in front of you if you like, to Romans 12, Romans 12, verse 9 to 13. Romans 12, 9 to 13 is the wedding passage that Victory and Natalie have chosen for their ceremony, and we're going to specifically be focusing in on verse 10. Romans 12, starting at verse 9. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. This is the word of the Lord. Family, friends of the bride and groom, all gathered here today. Today we have the exciting privilege of witnessing Victory Shumbusho, Natalie Thalen, your marriage. Victory and Natalie, I had the privilege of walking with both of you for a number of years now. I met you, Natalie, in Profession of Faith class a number of years ago, and then Victory and Natalie, you both joined for youth to help out with the youth group this last year, and that's been really fun. We've had lots of fun and meaningful times there, and then I got the privilege of getting to know you both better in pre-marriage class, and so that was really fun to walk through that together, and now here you are ready to get married. Time flies. Have you paused to take it all in? Now is the time to do that. You're sitting, no eyes are on you, just soak it up. This is your moment, and this is what we're all here for. For your marriage text, you chose Romans 12, verse 9 to 13, which says, love must be sincere, hate what is evil, cling to what is good. And then your text that you wanted us to zoom in on, be devoted to one another in love, honor one another above yourselves. This is a beautiful wedding text in the middle of a powerful passage that is jam-packed with marriage wisdom. And this passage gets to the heart of the secret of marriage, which, as it says, is honoring one another above or ahead of yourselves, putting one another first. The literal translation of the text here could mean letting the other person go ahead of you. There's a sense in this text that you'll both be doing this in your marriage, putting each other ahead of yourself. Now, I got to see that firsthand in marriage counseling class, pre-marriage counseling class. And I got to see it in your text that you sent me, and I'll read some excerpts from them a little bit later. But that begs the question, how does both of you put each other first? Have you thought about that? How can two people both put each other first? If you've ever watched that Warner Brothers cartoon about the chipmunks, you might remember how sweet they were to each other to the point of ridiculousness. If you haven't seen it, there's these two chipmunks that are so unbelievably sweet. They always, if they get to a doorway, they'll always say, you go first. No, 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 you go first. No, 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 you go first. And if we're to take this passage at face value, it would seem to say, Victory, Natalie, that you're both to have each other go first. But of course, as the cartoon points out, if we do that, you'll never get through the door. So how in the world do two people put each other first? Well, if you've ever taken a dance class, you'll know that in every dance, one person is designated to be the leader, and the other person is designated to be the follower. But there's a mystery in dance, because if you watch the dance as it progresses, you'll notice something. When a good couple dances, and we watch that, it becomes really hard to know who's leading and who's following. So this is a mystery that I'm going to unpack and that our text is going to unpack. And you'll see in a few moments. Victory, when I asked you why you want to marry Natalie, you said, I've been with Natalie for 8 years now, since grade 10. She's taught me to be patient, to be caring, to serve, to be a better leader, and to continually seek growth. And Natalie, when you shared why you wanted to marry Victory, you said, "Vic is a thoughtful and caring person. He always thinks of others." You said, "He is a person who leads me in my faith, and I see him as someone who would lead our entire family if that's something that God has in store for us." So there is a sense in which you've already decided there's going to be a leader and a follower, but there's a particular Christian mystery as to how Christian leadership works. Worldly leadership thinks that putting the needs of the other person first means becoming a doormat for them, just simply doing whatever they ask, even if it's unreasonable or ridiculous. Or worldly leadership, on the other extreme, says it means we can do whatever we want. We can lord it over a person if we think we know what's best for them. But in God's word, in the text that you've both chosen, it paints a very different picture of what a Christian marriage should look like. Christian leadership, as we know, is to become like Jesus, who, though he had all the power in the world, being united with God, he chose to make himself nothing, to become the servant of all, to be united to human beings, even human beings who betrayed him. That's why what your wedding text says is so important. Be devoted to one another in love. And then it says, honor. Honor one another ahead of yourselves. This is what your text means. This is the picture of Christian marriage that your text is giving us. And that honoring is an agreement to partner with God and his Holy Spirit to see the flourishing of the other person to be all that God has made them to be. Another translation of that verse says, show eagerness in honoring one another. I see that eagerness to honor one another in our classes and in what you shared. Another thing that you shared, Victory, is you said, when I think of a godly Christian woman to share the rest of my life with, Natalie is the perfect image of that woman. Honor. And Natalie, you said, Victory has always been supportive of me to do things I never thought I was capable of doing. He pushes me to be a better version of myself. I know I would not be the person I am today if it wasn't for him. Which is why Christian leadership is such a different thing. In Christian leadership, you truly honor the other person ahead of yourself. And Christian leadership has to do with listening. So if we take that picture of the dance couple, and that mystery, though there's a leader and there's a follower, it becomes really hard to know when you're watching who's leading and who's following. The reason for this is a really good dance leader listens to the heart of his partner. He listens to the impulses of his partner. He listens to her desires, where she wants to move, and gently guides the dance according to her desires. And we see that in what you shared when you said, she makes me want to be a better version of myself, and vice versa. Natalie, you said that about Victory. And in the same way, the dance follower listens to that gentle leadership that has guided and led her heart. And together, they make a beautiful dance that through putting one another first reveals they are not just moving with one person leading and one person following, but both of you, in putting each other first, recognize that you are both responding to the Spirit. In dance, we see the metaphor play out with music. You're both listening to the music and to one another and moving along with the music. And in the Christian marriage, it's no different. In a Christian marriage, though, you don't listen to music. You listen to the Spirit. Romans 8 encourages us to keep in step with the Spirit. And here is the first mystery, or another mystery, I want to drive home. And that is, in putting one another first, you're putting God first. And I see that in both of you. In dance, when we observers can't tell who is leading and who is following, It's because both partners are so intent on listening to one another and listening to the music that they're in sync and in step with the music. And in Christian marriage, as I said, the Holy Spirit of God, from whom we learn all throughout the Bible, he will be your best dance instructor for your marriage. So keep him front and center. Keep in step with the Spirit of God. The scriptures are clear. God is real. His word is living and active, sharper than a double-edged sword. And if you listen to his Spirit, which speaks to you in his word, he will continue to inspire you, continue to heal you, continue to draw you to one another in love as you put God first. Our text continues on that note of putting God first. It says, never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor. Keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. But the text doesn't end there. There's one more mystery I want us to dwell on this morning. I want you, it's particularly the two of you. It says, the final verse in the text that you chose says, share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. So this is going to sound funny at first, but as we talk about marriage, marriage is not just about the two of you. It's not only about the two of you. We've already seen how in serving one another, your marriage becomes about God. And then our text reveals to us by shifting right into God and then into hospitality that your marriage is also about those around you, your community, those of us gathered here. Because as you keep in step with the Spirit and grow and change according to how he leads and guides both of you, that transformation is not just a gift for the two of you. It will bless you in your work. It will bless you in all of your relationships. It will bless you in your families. As the two of you cultivate a safe space for love and intimacy, it could be, as you mentioned, Natalie, that it's the will of God to bless you with children. And then you will practice hospitality by allowing your marriage to be a safe space for children to raise and grow in the faith to be lovers and disciples of Jesus. But if children don't come right away, or even at all, the call to hospitality is the same. Your relationship between the two of you has gathered and garnered so much growth, kindness, and transformative love in each of you that marriage is the chance to share that with others. Invite people into your homes. Show love and kindness in walking alongside single people, poor people, homeless people, which I know you both do so well in your different jobs already. And now you can continue to practice that hospitality as a team in your marriage for the rest of your lives. As the scripture says, be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. First in a marriage for one another, for God, and then as a marital unit for the sake of the world. So God bless you both in your marriage, and may your marriage draw both of you deeper into a knowledge of the triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm going to invite the wedding party to come back up again, and then I'm going to invite you, Victory and Natalie, to come back up and join me at the front for the exchange of your vows. It is now time for the exchange of the vows. Let's pray. Loving God, as we move to the exchanging of the vows and the rings, will you bind this two together in the power of your Holy Spirit to be one as you are one. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Victory. Do you take Natalie to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, protect her, and, forsaking all others, Be faithful to her as long as you both shall live.
I do.
And Natalie, do you take victory to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
I will have the rings now. All right. Victory, you are first. And take Natalie's left hand and invite you, Victory, to repeat after me. I, Victory,
I gobble. Victory.
Sorry. I, Victory, Ngabo Shumbusho.
I, Victory, Ngabo Shumbusho.
Take you, Natalie Danielle Thalen.
Thank you, Natalie Danielle Thalen.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us apart.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
I, Natalie Danielle Thalen.
I, Natalie Danielle Thalen.
Take you, Victory Ngabo Shumbusho.
Take you, Victory Ngabo Shumbusho.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And now I invite you to hold each other's ring hands and repeat after me one more time. Natalie, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
Natalie, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And Natalie, I invite you to take Victory's ring finger in your hand and repeat after me. Victory, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
Victory, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son.
Father, Son.
And Holy Spirit.
And Holy Spirit.
Amen. At this point, the bride and the groom will participate in a unity ceremony. There's a sand station set up over there, and this ceremony will represent two worlds becoming one. Just as the individual grains of sand can never be separated, this symbol symbolizes the unity of Victory and Natalie. What God has joined together, let no one separate. So they'll head over now to participate in the unity symbol, and then proceed without announcement to the signing of the marriage registry. And Victory's nephew, Callum, will come forward, and he will play us some music.
Thank you.
Now, as a minister in the Church of Christ, and by the authority which is vested in me by the province of British Columbia, I now pronounce you, Victory and Natalie, husband and wife, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Victory, you may kiss the bride. All right. After the ceremony, the bride and groom would love for you to join them in a receiving line just out the front doors, all the way out the front doors. And then to your right will be the receiving line. And then also to your right, there will be another entrance right after the receiving line back into the fellowship hall for some refreshments. I'm told there will be a lovely charcuterie board, so you're not going to want to miss that. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce, for the first time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Victory and Natalie Shumbusho.